I welcome you back to the presentation on analysis of determinate structures, and we are continuing the discussion with respect to analysis of simply supported beams for various types of loads using influence line diagrams. In this presentation, we shall try to consider analysis of simply supported beam carrying two concentrated V loads spaced at a fixed distance using influence line diagram. If you just look at the picture here, so these are two abutments that we have here, or the piers or columns in a bridge, and you have a girder of quite considerable span. And please note that generally in case of bridges, the beams are simply supported. And if you just try to look at this vehicle moving on the bridge, the point of contact is at these two wheels or the axles, where we have the axles. So physically we can understand that, okay, the load, the entire load of the automobile is transferred, okay, at the front wheel and the rear wheel, okay, and as the car moves or the automobile moves, okay, the load also keeps moving, okay, along with the vehicle. So we are trying to deal with such kind of a problem, okay, in this particular discussion. So let me start with a numerical problem with respect to this. We have two concentrated wheel loads of 15 kilonewtons and 10 kilonewtons. Okay, the load transferred by the front wheel is 15, the rear wheel is 10 kN, the distance between the two is 3 meters. It crosses a simply supported beam of span 12 meters from left to right with 15 kilonewton load leading, that is the front load. So we are trying to calculate quite a number of things here. There is find the first one, maximum bending moment, okay, at a given section, which is 5 meters from the left support. Second objective, maximum shear force, which is developed at a section, okay, 5 meters from the left support, okay, and absolute maximum bending moment in the beam. Again, maximum BM developed under 9 kN load at the second load, absolute maximum shear force in the beam, equivalent UDL over the entire span based on absolute maximum BM, and the last one, equivalent UDL over the entire span based on absolute maximum shear force, okay, using influence plane diagram. So anyway, let us try to take these objectives one by one, and let us try to calculate all these things. Now let us start with the first objective, to find the maximum bending moment developed at a given section 5 meters from the left support when the two moving loads cross the beam. So as the problem states, so you have got a 15 kiloton, okay, one load, the next one is 10 kN, the distance between the two is 3 meter, so that is always constant. As a load 15 kN starts to cross the beam from left to right, the second load 10 kN keeps following 15 kN at a distance of 3 meters. Now here we are trying to find the maximum bending moment that develops at 5 meters from the left support. That means section C is defined, okay, and we are trying to calculate the bending moment at that point. So first let us try to understand, okay, how exactly we deal with this particular problem. Now please understand, the bending moment at section C, okay, will be maximum when one of the two loads act on the beam. So either 15 kN should be acting at that point, or 10 kN load should be acting at that point. So this is the first thing that we need to understand. Okay, so normally we don't try to identify which load, okay, should be placed at C to get maximum BM, okay, when we are dealing with two concentrated load. However, when we are dealing with multiple wheel loads, we will try to do a simple test, identify which load should be placed at C at that section to get maximum BM. However, when we have two loads, okay, we are trying to do the problem in trial and error procedure, in the sense that we first place 15 kN load at C, determine the value, and again try to place the second load and again determine. Like for example, okay, so we just try to look at this case. So we have maximum beniment, okay, will be occurring at C. So what we are trying to do is we are trying to place, okay, 15 kN load at C, and then we are trying to determine the value. Now first let us try to draw the influence line diagram for beniment at C. Now please understand, okay, small a is 5 meters, okay, that is distance AC, and small b, that is distance BC, is 7 meters, okay. So how do we calculate the ordinate? AB by L, that is 5 into 7 divided by 12 is 2.917 is what we are trying to get, okay. So once you get that value, is it all right? So please understand, okay, so we are trying to now push the load, okay, such that the first wheel load is at 15 kN. Please understand, the second load is trailing the first load by 3 meters. So we are also now trying to calculate the ordinate in ILD, okay, under 10 kN. So it is quite simple. We try to use similar triangles. So that means at 5 meters, okay, the ordinate is 2.917. At 2 meters, what is the value? So the value is 1.167. Now having got the value of the ordinates under the two wheel loads, we use the simple expression. So beniment at C is nothing but the algebraic summation of intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load. Since there are two loads, we have two terms. Okay, the first one is 10 kN multiplied by 1.167 plus the next load, 15 kN multiplied by the ordinate under that, that is 2.917. So when you just try to add the two, that is 10 into 1.167, 15 into 2.917, it gives you the value of moment at C, that is 55.425 kN, okay, when 15 kN load is acting at C. Okay, but however, we are not sure whether this is the maximum, okay, that will be developed at C, because the other option is we try to place the next load, that is 10 kN at C, and again calculate the bending moment corresponding to this position of load. So now we try to move the load further, that means we are trying to apply the same ILD, because you are trying to calculate the bending moment at the same section, so the influence line diagram does not change. The only thing that changes is the position of the load. So now we try to push the load further, that means 15 kN load is pushed further such that 10 kN load acts at C. So once 10 kN load acts at C, please understand 15 kN is to the right of 10 kN by distance of 3 meters. So please understand the entire distance from B to C is 7, because the distance between the two loads is 3 meters, distance from 15 kN load to B is support B is 4 meters. So the maximum ordinate at C, okay, in ILD is 2.917, which is at a distance of 7 meters from B. So we use similar triangles. So that means at 7 meters from B, the ordinate is 2.917. At 4 meters from B, what is the ordinate? You just try to calculate the value using rule of 3. So the value that we get is 1.667. Now we know the ordinates in ILD under both the loads. So we now use the simple expression, that is bending moment at C is equal to sigma. That means we have to consider, okay, this expression for all the loads. Okay, what is the expression? Intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load. Okay, so again we have two loads and two corresponding ordinates. You multiply each of the load by the corresponding ordinate, take the sum, you get the bending moment at C for this position of load. So we get this as 10 into 2.917 plus 15 into 1.667, which is nothing but 54.175 kN meter when the load is at C. Now we try to do a comparison. So that means we try to compare the values of MC we have got with respect to both the positions. Okay, when we have placed 15 kilonewton load at C, the value of bending moment is 55.425, and when the load is 10 kN load is acting at C, the bending moment is 54.175 kN meter. We try to compare the two, and you can easily check that. Okay, the bending moment at C is maximum when 15 kilonewton load is acting at C. Okay, and hence the maximum bending moment that will be developed at the given section C, which is 5 meters from the left support, is 55.425 kN. So I hope you have understood. It's a very simple exercise. So whatever may be the given section, okay, so we just try to write the appropriate ILD, that is influence line diagram, for BM at that point. Okay, and then we try to first place the first load, okay, at C, okay, and then obviously the second load will be trailing by that, okay, at some given distance. Then try to calculate the bending moment at C with that position. Then allow the beams to move further such that the second load acts at C. Again, for that position, you again calculate the bending moment, okay, at C. Please understand, the influence line diagram remains same for both the positions, okay, for all the loads, because you are drawing the bending ILD for the given section, not for the position of load. So compare and then try to tell which is the maximum value. Now we go to the next objective. The next objective would be to calculate the maximum shear force developed at a given section, which is 5 meters from right support. So we can try to give the positions, okay, with respect to any of the supports, right? So here it has been said that it is a distance of 5 meters from right support when the two moving loads cross the beam. Okay, so here also we are trying to do the same kind of approach. That means, okay, we try to say that the shear force at C, that is given section, okay, will be maximum when one of the two moving loads will be acting at the given section. So what we do is we first draw the ILD, appropriate ILD, keep the first load, okay, at C, okay, then calculate and then move the load further, okay, and then calculate, compare and then tell which is the maximum value. So let us first try to draw the appropriate influence line diagram, that is the influence line diagram, okay, for shear force at C. So if you just try to check, the shape of the ILD is something like this. I hope now you are all very familiar with the shape of the influence line diagram for shear force. So it has two right angle triangles, okay, that is one below the baseline and one above the baseline. This ordinate, okay, below the baseline is A by L. So what is A? A is nothing but distance AC. So because in this particular case, okay, section C is defined with respect to right support, it says it is 5 meters from the right support. So obviously this is nothing but span minus B, that is 7 meters. 7 plus 5 is 12 meter is the span. Okay, so this ordinate, the ordinate below the baseline, is given by A by L, which is nothing but 7 by 12, which is 0.583, and the ordinate above the baseline, which is nothing but A by L, which is 5 by 12, which is 0.417. And please note that, okay, the ordinates above the baseline are all positive, that is the ordinates in portion CB are positive, and the ordinates in portion AC, which are below the baseline, are all negative. Okay, first draw the appropriate influence line diagram. Then place the first load, that is 15 kilonewton load, okay, at C. So having placed the 15 kilonewton load at C, we need to calculate the ordinates under the loads. At 15 kilonewtons already, that is at C, already ordinates are defined. So we have to calculate the ordinate under 10 kilonewton. So which can be done using similar triangles. So please understand that AC is 7 meters, because distance between the two loads is 3 meters, distance between A and the 10 kN load will be 4 meters. Okay, so this is how you can split this 7 meters conveniently. Now we make use of this information to calculate the ordinate under 10 kN. That is at 7 meters, at distance AC, the ordinate, okay, that is below the baseline, is 0.583. Hence, at a distance of 4 meters, what will be this ordinate? Again, rule of 3, you get this as 0.333. Again, this is negative. Okay, so once you have done this, so we now try to calculate the value of shear force for this position, okay, of load at C. Correct. Now, how do we calculate shear force at C? Is again sigma, that is summation, okay, of all the terms connected with the loads, that is intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the loads. There are two loads, so we'll have two terms. Okay, one due to 10 kilonewton, one due to 15 kilonewton. Okay, how do we start with 10 kilonewton? It is 10 into minus 0.333. Please understand, the ordinate, okay, below the baselines are all negative. So we have to take it as minus 0.333 plus, okay, 15. So we have two choices here for 15, either 0.417 or minus 0.583. So I would advise that you take minus here, okay, for I'm sorry, this is not 0.417, this should be minus 0.583, this should be minus 0.583. You have to take the negative value here, you take the negative value here, okay, and then multiply with 15, okay, because please understand, if you take plus 0.417, okay, the first term will be negative, the second term will be positive, okay, and then once you try to add the two algebraically, the value reduces. So what we would like to advise here is, strictly speaking, right, okay, so try to take the same signs, okay, for both the ordinates. However, if the loads are abnormally different, then you can try an extra combination here. That is, okay, obviously for 10 kilonewton, the ordinate is minus 0.33. For 15, you can try once minus 0.583 and once plus 0.417, one of the ordinates, okay, and then try to calculate, okay, and then try to decide, okay, which is maximum. Finally, we would like to take a statement like that, okay. For example, for this particular value, I think I have tried to calculate, and I've concluded it as minus 9.585 kilonewtons, okay. Now, if you just try to go to the next position of load, now I would like to start again. I would now want to place 10 kilonewton load, okay, at C. So if you just try to check this, how, okay, the loads would be positioned. I am placing 10 kN load at C. Obviously, 15 kN will be to the right of C by distance of 3 meters. So the entire distance from C to B is 5 meters. So obviously, distance from 15 kilonewton load to B would be 2 meters. So the next thing would be to calculate the ordinate, okay, in ILD under 15 kilonewtons. So that would be, that is at 5 meters, okay, the value is, okay, 0.417. So at a distance of 2 meters, the ordinate would be 0.167. So having calculated this, now I would like to calculate the shear force at C. Now please understand, under 15 kilonewton load, we have a positive ordinate. So again, I would advise you to take the positive ordinate, okay, under 10 kN. So that would be 10 into plus 0.417 plus 15 into 0.167. Under 15 kilonewton load, you don't have a choice, but at C there are two ordinates and you have a choice, and you have to take an appropriate value. If you have any confusion, you can try both, once with negative, once with positive, and you can just try to have two more values here instead of one, and then again try to compare and then try to tell which is the maximum. So here, for this particular calculation, I've got this as plus 6.675 kN. Right, now I just try to make a comparison. So when we have placed 15 kilonewton load at C, it is minus 9.585. when I place 10 kilonewton load at C, I've got it as 6.675. I do a comparison here. I'm trying to take the value magnitude, and I'm not talking about the sign. The sign will always try to tell you whether the force is upwards or downwards. So what we are more worried is, okay, the value of the force, okay, here. So I would be trying to say that, okay, maximum shear force develops at C, okay, when 15 kilonewton load acts at C, and the numerical value is 9.585 kilonewton. So again, the approach adopted is very similar to that we followed in case of calculating bending moment, maximum bending moment at a given section. So again, it could be by trial and error. It is by trial and error. You place first load, calculate. You place the second load, calculate. However, when you place the first load, at the load point there are two ordinates. Probably you can try both, okay, once the positive ordinate, once the negative ordinate. You may get two values when you take 15 kilonewton load at C. Again, when you push, okay, and make the 10 kN load acting at C, So again, you can have two more choices, taking positive and negative, compare all the four and then try to say which is maximum. This is a simpler approach, okay, of trying to do the problem under two concentrated wheel load. But however, when we go to multiple wheel loads, we don't do trial and error. We try to use, we try to do a test and then try to determine which load should be placed at C to get maximum shear force at C. Now let us try to go to the next objective, that is to find absolute maximum bending moment in the beam, okay, when the two moving loads cross the beam. So if you just try to check here, so I have got again the same problem, okay, 15 kN, 10 kN, okay, spaced at 3 meters, the load starts to move. So please understand, okay, so there would be one section, okay, which experiences the maximum bending moment, okay, when this load moves from A to B or crosses the beam, and that will occur at some given position of the load. So please understand, we would like to do this, okay, exercise, okay. So please understand, we are trying to give you a statement right now, but we have a small book work coming up once we finish this problem regarding this particular condition. So please understand this very, very carefully. Absolute maximum BM develops in the beam under the larger wheel load. So generally we give you two wheel loads which are of different values, okay. So if you take the problem 10 kN and 15 kN, so obviously 15 kN is larger in this case. It is not necessary that the first load entering the beam should be larger, it could be the second load also could be larger. So please understand, absolute maximum bending moment always occurs under the larger wheel load, okay, for what position of load is what you need to understand, okay, when, okay, the mid span bisects the resultant and the larger wheel load. So when it keeps on moving, there would be a situation where, okay, the mid span will be exactly between the resultant and the larger wheel load, okay. So when the load is at this position, okay, so please understand, maximum BM, okay, developed in the beam, okay, will be at the section, okay, which will be carrying 15 kN load, okay, is what we need to understand, okay. So let me just try to take you through this particular case. So please understand, so this involves calculating the resultant. So the first few steps would be to identify resultant, where exactly the resultant occurs, and then try to place the load properly and then calculate the bending moment, okay. So first let us try to, my first attempt is to calculate the resultant of the two wheel loads. So the two wheel loads are 15 and 10. So how do I calculate the resultant? Resultant is the summation of the two loads. That is 10 plus 15. So we will be giving you two values. So you just try to add the two. 10 plus 15. That will give you the value of resultant. Now where will be the result? Where will you expect the resultant to lie? The resultant will lie between the two wheel loads. That is 10 and 15. So it occurs between the two. You cannot expect the resultant to be away. That is away from 15 or to the right of 15 or to the left of 10. It has to be between 10 and 15 is what you can understand, okay. So resultant lies between the two loads. So let me assume that, okay, the distance of the resultant from 10 kN is x, okay, x. So what will be the distance of the resultant from 15? It is total distance, is spacing is 3 meters, so 3 minus x, okay, is what we are trying to say. X is, let x be the distance of the resultant from 10. So 3 minus x is nothing but the distance of the resultant from 15 kN, okay, is what we are trying to tell you. Okay, now the next one is, we have to find x. How do I get the value of x? It's quite simple. We try to equate the moment of resultant to the moment of the two forces about any point, but generally we take the left extreme load is what we are trying to say. So first I would like to take the moment of R about 10 kN and equate it to moment of 10 kN and 15 kN about the same point. So they have to be the same, right? So we equate moment of R with the moments of, okay, W1, okay, about the left load, plus, okay, moment of W2 again about the left load is what we are trying to tell you, okay, both the moments. So please understand, we get this as R into X, that is the moment of resultant about the first load equal to moment of, okay, the two loads about the same point, that is 10 into 0, because you are taking the moment of 10 about this point itself, it is 0, plus 15 into distance is 3. So the only unknown is x, because the resultant already we have calculated, that is 25 kN, it comes to 1.8 meters. So what is 1.8 meters? X. So that means this value is 1.8. If this is 1.8, so distance would be, there are to the right, 3 minus x, that would be 1.2 meters. You can observe common sense, that is resultant is closer towards the larger wheel load, okay, and slightly away from the smaller wheel load. Please understand. However, if the second load, that is instead of 10 kN load, I had given 20, the resultant would have been to the left, okay, towards left, okay, or towards this load, larger load. Right now, please understand, if there is a situation where both the loads are same, so resultant would be acting right at the midpoint. Now we have identified the resultant and its position. Okay, now having identified the resultant where it lies, next we talk about the condition. So condition is what? Okay, the mid span should bisect the resultant and the larger wheel load. So look at this, the larger wheel load is 15, the resultant is here. So distance between the two is 1.2. Now please understand, the mid span should lie exactly between the two is what we are trying to tell. So that means, so I am just trying to draw a mid span here, a line between R and 15 kN load. Why 15? Larger wheel load. You should always try to write this line, okay, and call it as the mid span, okay, between the resultant and the larger wheel load. For example, if this, the left one, were to be a larger wheel load, I should have drawn the mid span here, bisecting the 10 kN load and R. Here, I am just trying to draw a line between resultant R and 15 kN load, bisecting it. So this is 1.2, so I get 0.6 and 0.6 meters. So please note, okay, now you have to understand, where should I place the 15 kN load, okay, on the beam. So this is important, okay. So please understand, what is the condition? Mid span should bisect resultant and the larger wheel load, that is 15 kN. Once you have understood this, okay, my first objective would be to place 15 kN load to the right of mid span by a distance of 0.6 meters. So that is my key, okay, to this particular position. Okay, that's how I start trying to put the loads on the beam. So please remember, okay, I am going to now place 15 kN load to the right of mid span by a distance of 0.6 meters. So let me first again locate the mid span. Okay, so what is the distance? What's the length? 12 meters. So mid span is exactly between A and B. So that is 6 meters. I've identified the mid span. Now I should place 15 kN load to begin with. Where do I place 15 kN load? To the right of mid span at a distance of 0.6 meters. So please understand, I have placed 15 kN load to the right of mid span at a distance of 0.6 meters. So once I have placed this as 0.6, the distance from mid span to B was 6 meters. So if this is 0.6, this will be distance from 15 kN load to B is 5.4 meters. Now I have placed the first load, 15 kN load. Where will be the second load? Second load will be to the left of 15 kN load at a distance of, okay, 3 meters. So now I place 10 kN load, okay, to the left of 15 kN load at a distance of 3 meters. Already distance from 15 to mid span is 0.6. So further to the left of 2.4 meters, I write my second load 10 kN. So this is very simple. You need to understand. First, place the first load, larger load, on the wheel load. Relatively, okay, try to put the second load on the beam, correct? So my second load here is at 3 meters from 15, so already there is 0.6, then another 2.4. now distance from this vertical line, which is mid span, to point A, okay, 6 meters. So if this is 2.4 meters, this is 3.6 meters. You can easily understand, okay, this is not at all difficult. You can have to just try to do it in a very systematic way. Now having done this, first let us try to now understand, okay, we have placed the load properly. So where does the maximum bending moment occur? Absolute maximum bending moment occurs under the larger wheel load, that is 15 kN load. So that means now we have defined section C. So look at this, okay, now I call this point, that is 15 kN load, as point C. That is point C. So if that is point C, now let me rewrite the numbers. So distance from B to point C is 5.4, correct? Distance between the two wheel loads is 3 meters. and distance from 10 kN to load to support is 3.6. Okay, now I am calling this point as C point. Okay, so my small a, distance AC will be 3.6 plus 3, that is 6.6, and distance BC is 5.4 meters. Please remember, okay, C is here, okay, which is at a distance of 6.6 meters from A or 5.4 meters from B. Correct? So I am rewriting that figure again. Okay, this is the figure, the same figure as what I have written. Now I am writing the appropriate, okay, ILD. So I am writing the ILD for BM at C. Okay, so it looks like a triangle. It has a maximum ordinate at C. And how do we get this maximum ordinate? AB by L. So what is A? 6.6 meters. What is B? 5.4 meters. What is the total span? 12 meters. So multiply, you get this value as 2.97. So please understand, okay, so this ordinate, okay, is under 15 kN. However, we also need to calculate ordinate under 10 kN. So how do we do this? By similar triangle. That means at a distance of 6.6 meters, this is 2.97. At a distance of 3.6 meters, okay, what is the ordinate? Okay, so that would be 1.62. Correct. Now, having got the value of the ordinate, okay, at 3.6 meters, okay, now we try to use the expression, that is, bending moment at C is nothing but sigma. So this expression is the same. Okay, intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load for each and every load which we try to algebraically add. Here both the ordinates are positive. So absolute maximum BM, that is M suffix C, equal to 10 into 1.62. Plus 15 into 2.97, okay, which comes to, okay, 60.75 kilonewton meter, okay, which occurs under 15 kilonewton load. Correct? So this is how you need to calculate the value of absolute maximum BM. So please understand, how did we go? We just try to quickly recollect. We first identify the resultant, calculate the magnitude and the location, okay, and then place the mid span exactly between the resultant and the larger wheel load. Understand at what distance do we have the 15 kilonewton load with respect to midspan? Is it to the right or to the left? Identify that properly and then put that load, okay, exactly on the beam with respect to midspan, okay, and then write the second load, okay, relatively with respect to that larger wheel load, okay, and then try to call section C as the section right under the larger wheel load. So small a and small b are defined. Okay, draw the ILD, okay, also calculate the ordinate at the other wheel load, then use the expression. So it's a very simple way of trying to calculate the absolute maximum shear force. Now coming to the next one, to find absolute maximum shear force in the beam when the two moving loads cross the beam. Now we have a specific condition here. The condition states that absolute maximum shear force develops in the beam, okay, at one of the supports. It's not simultaneously, either it may occur at left support or at right support, okay, it occurs at only one support, okay, not both, okay. If you talk about same loads, then we have both it will be, it can develop here or there depending upon the position. So when we have unequal loads, it will occur at either left support or at right support, okay, right, okay, at which, this is important, at one of the supports to which the resultant comes closest when one of the wheel load is placed over the support and the other is acting on the beam. Okay, so that means it may act at left or right. When does it occur? When one of the load should be acting at that support and the other one should be acting on the beam. So to make you understand this, okay, I have a simple figure here which is self-explanatory, you can understand. So once the wheel starts to move, please understand, I am just trying to place the load such that, okay, the when 15 kN load is acting at A, please understand 10 kN load is not acting on the beam. So this cannot be considered for maximum shear force. So I generally try to move it further. Is it all right? Okay, I again move it further like this. Okay, so once the other one is on the beam, right? So 10 kN is acting at A. So now I understand where is the resultant. Okay, so resultant is obviously nearer 15 kN. Okay, it is more than half the distance, That is, I think if you just try to quickly recollect, 1.8 meters, okay, from 10 kiloton was the resultant. Okay, when the load is occupying like this, right, the resultant is at a distance of 1.8 meters from me. Now I keep moving, and at one situation, okay, the load would be something like this. That means 15 kiloton load is at support B, okay, and 10 kiloton load is acting at acting on the beam. So if you just try to check where is the resultant, it is a distance of 1.2 meters from B. Here it is 1.8, here it is 1.2. So the condition states that, okay, it occurs at one of the supports, okay, when the resultant, resultant comes closest to the support, okay, when you place one wheel load on the support and the other load on the beam. This is the context, okay. But however, we can do this problem in a much simpler way rather than trying to understand this, okay. In case of two concentrated wheel loads, we always try to make a statement like this, okay. It occurs at the left support when the second load is larger, that is W2, the following load is larger, because when the following load is larger, the resultant is closer to W2, okay. Or it occurs at the right support, okay, when the leading load is larger. This is what you need to understand, simple, okay. If the first load is larger, it occurs at the right support. If the second load is larger, it occurs at the left support, when you place the load appropriately. That is, one of the load has to be placed on the beam, okay, properly. This is how you need to understand. For the given example, the first load is larger than the second load, and hence where do we place the load? Obviously at the right support. So please understand, okay, we try to place the load like this, okay. If the second load were to be a larger, I would have placed it on the left side. Now I draw the appropriate influence line diagram, correct. So we are talking about maximum shear force occurs at the support, correct. So I have to draw the ILD for vertical reaction at B. So now I draw the ILD for vertical reaction at B. So it looks like a triangle, okay. I hope you should be familiar with this, correct. So the maximum ordinate for ILD at for VB is 1, which is at B, okay. So for 15 kiloton, you already have the ordinate. For 10, okay, we need to calculate. How do we calculate? Similar triangle. At 12 meters, it is 1. At 9 meters, what is the value? That is 0.975. Having computed the two values, okay, I now try to use the equation, okay. Shear force at B, right support, equal to sigma. That is, there are two loads, that's why sigma, okay. For each load, it is intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load, okay. So it is 10 into 7.75 plus 15 into 1, that would be plus 22.5, okay, which occurs at B when 15 kilonewton load is acting at B, is what you need to understand. So this is how we try to calculate the value of absolute maximum shear force, okay, at B, correct. Now let us try to calculate another important thing here, that is to find the maximum bending moment under 10 kiloton load when the two moving loads crosses the beam. Is it all right? So that means earlier we had talked about to find the absolute maximum bending moment in the beam, okay. So please understand, when we did that case, we said absolute maximum bending moment occurs under the larger wheel load, okay. There are two wheel loads, 15 kiloton, correct, under a given condition. So please understand, now we are talking about the smaller wheel load, okay. To find the maximum bending moment under 10 kN load when the two moving wheel loads cross the beam, that means when the two loads starts to move, please understand 10 kiloton load is behind a 15 kiloton load, okay, and it occupies different positions as it starts to move from A to B, correct, right. So at each instant, okay, when it is at 1 meter from A, there is some bending moment under 10 kiloton load. When 10 kiloton load is 2 meters, there is some bending moment under 10 kiloton load. When 10 kiloton load is at 3 meters from A, there is some bending moment. So imagine that, okay, so at each position, it's having some value of bending moment, and what we are trying to tell here is, or calculate, what is the maximum bending moment that we can expect to develop under 10 kiloton load. Please understand, this procedure is absolutely the same as that of absolute maximum bending moment. The only thing is, when we try to put the position on the beam, okay, so mid-span will not be between larger wheel load and resultant. It will be the load that we are talking about, the smaller load and the resultant. So let us try to go through this this exercise. Okay, so we try to say maximum bending moment develops under any given load, that is right now 10 kN load, when the mid span bisects the resultant and the given wheel load. So when we do this case, okay, so again we need to calculate the resultant. So we are repeating the same steps, okay, that we did in case of your absolute maximum BM, and it will be a sort of revision for you regarding the calculation of resultant. So what is the first thing that we do here? Okay, we try to calculate the resultant. How do we calculate the resultant? It is a summation of 10 plus 15, that is 25 kN. Then we try to say where does the resultant act? It acts between the two loads. Okay, at what distance? Let x be the distance, okay, of the resultant from 10 kN. So the distance of the resultant from 15 is 3 minus x. Now how do we calculate the resultant? You take the moment of resultant about 10 kN and equate it to the moments of both 15 and 10 kN about the same load. Okay, right? Okay, so we find to find x, equate the moment of R with the moments, okay, of both W1 and W2, okay, with respect to 10 kN load, correct, with respect to that. So we now get the expression. So moment of R about 10 is R into x. Moment of both 10 and 15 about 10 kN load would be 10 into 0 plus 15 into 3, that would be x equal to 1.8 meters. Okay, now once we try to say that this is 1.8, so please understand this is 1.8, 3 minus x is 1.2 meters, correct? So this is, up to this things are very same. Okay, when you just talk about either absolute maximum BM or BM under the smaller wheel load. Okay, the next thing is, okay, we talk about the condition. The condition we are trying to take here is, okay, mid span should bisect the resultant and the load we are talking about. So last time we always say it is with respect to the larger wheel load. Now it is a smaller wheel load we are trying to consider. So now we consider the mid span. So I draw the mid span, okay, between R and 10, exactly between the two. So distance from R to 10 is 1.8 meters. So obviously, okay, so distance from mid span to either 10 or R is 0.9 meters. Correct? So please understand, okay, so this is the key for you to place the load. That means how do I place the load right now? I start with 10 kN load. Last time I was starting with 15. I put the 15 kN load to begin with on the beam. Now I am trying to put 10 kN load on the beam to begin with. Where do I position it? I position 10 kN load to the left of mid span at a distance of 0.9 meters. I repeat, okay, so just try to check the mid span is here. So with respect to mid span, 10 kN load is to the left at a distance of 0.9 meters. Correct? Now I place the load. First I locate the mid span. Yeah, I locate the mid span. So span is 12 meters. So mid span is here, 6 meters from both supports A and B. Now I place 10 kN load to begin with on the beam, and that should be to the left of mid span at a distance of 0.9 meters. Okay, so this is how I place the to begin with my load. I start with 10 kN. Correct? Now please understand, distance from A to mid span is 6 meters. So if this is 0.9 meters, okay, so distance from A to 10 kN is 5.1 meters. Correct? Now I place the next load, that is 15 kN load. Where do I put it? To the right. At what distance? 3 meters. Okay, from 10 kN. So look at this. Okay, so total is 3. Already this distance is 0.9. So further to the right, okay, from mid span at a distance of 2.1 meters, I have 15 kilonewtons. Okay, so distance from midpoint to C, to support B, is 6 meters. If this is 2.1 meter, this has to be 3.9 meters because the sum of that should be 6 meters. I hope this is clear up to this point. Now we identify section C. Right? So where exactly we are trying, what is it that we are trying to calculate? Where are we calculating bending moment? It is at 10 kN load. So now point C gets defined. Okay, point C is now under 10 kN. Last time point C was under 15 kN load for that position. Now I am trying to calculate bending moment under 10 kN. So C gets defined. Correct? So where are we trying to calculate? This is the section. So once C is defined, so let's try to again work these distances. So from A to 10 kN load is 5.1, distance between the two wheel loads is 3 meters, and obviously distance from 15 kN to support B is 3.9 meters. Having defined section C, my small distance A, small is A is 5.1 meters, distance AC is 5.1, distance CB is 6.9 meters, correct? 6.9 meters. Okay, now having got the values of A and B, I draw the appropriate inference line diagram. So A is 5.1 meters, B is 6.9 meters. Okay, I draw the inference line diagram for bending moment for this section C, which is having a maximum ordinate AB by L. Okay, that is 5.1 into 6.9 divided by 12 is 2.933. And right above this, we have this 10 kN load. My next task is to calculate the ordinate under 15 kN load. So again, I use similar triangles here to get this value. So that means at a distance of, okay, that is 3 plus 3.9, that is 6.9 meters, it is 2.933. At a distance of 3.9, what is the value? I can use rule of 3 and then get this number, 1.658. Having calculated the two ordinates under the loads, I use the expression, that is bending moment at C is sigma of intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load. So that is under maximum BM under 10 kN MC equal to 10 into 2.933 plus 15 into 1.658, which sums up to 54.2 kN meter. Now just try to recollect, the absolute maximum BM was larger than this value. You can cross check, okay, that value. So this cannot be more than the absolute maximum BM. I hope you have understood this. So the way we try to do this exercise, okay, is very similar to what we have done, okay, for absolute maximum BM. Now we have two simple objectives, okay, to find. The first one is the equivalent UDL, okay, over the entire span based on absolute maximum BM. So what we assume is, we imagine, okay, an equivalent UDL to be spread over the entire beam. So what we are trying to understand is, what would be the intensity of this UDL, right, if it has to produce the same value of absolute maximum bending moment that we have calculated in the given problem. So please understand, okay, for the given problem, we already have calculated the absolute maximum bending moment as 60.75 kNm, correct, for that two concentrated wheel load. Now what we are doing is, assuming that we have an equivalent UDL, what will be the intensity? For an equivalent UDL, the maximum bending moment occurs at the mid-span and the value is given as WL square by 8. Correct? Now we physically equate the two. That is WL square by 8 equal to 60.75. So we equate Mmax, okay, that is WL square by 8 equal to absolute maximum BM, that is 60.75. Okay, the value of L is 12 meters, please understand, it's not 15, it is 12. Okay, we try to simplify this. Okay, so that is 12. Okay, we have substituted properly. So that is 12 is the correct value. So 60.75 into 8 divided by 12 square, the value of W is 3.375 kN meter. So that means if you take the beam, a simply support beam of 12 meters and put a value of 3.375 kN per meter on this, it will also produce the same value of absolute maximum BM. So the same sort of attempt is made to calculate that is equivalent UDL with respect to absolute maximum shear force. So we've taken a simply supported beam, UDL throughout. Okay, so you can understand the maximum reaction occurs at the support, and what is the reaction? Total load by 2, that is WL by 2. So L is 12 meters here, again not 15. Okay, so we are trying to do this calculation. So we have calculated absolute maximum shear force as 22.5. Okay, and the value of maximum shear force is WL by 2, total load by 2. You equate the two. Okay, maximum SF equal to absolute max BM. Okay, WL by 2 equal to 22.5. You can rearrange and then try to get what is WE. Correct substitution of L is made here, 12 meters, and we've got the equivalent load as 3.75 kN per meter. So I hope you have understood how this problem is solved. Okay, I hope there should be difficulty to solve this problem. So however, there is one small book work that we normally try to do showing that condition. There is that to get the absolute maximum BM, right? Okay, so it always occurs at the larger wheel load. Okay, when the mid-span bisects the larger wheel load and the resultant. I think that part we will try to take up in the next presentation. I think we will close the presentation for this for today.